In this video, we're going to talk about adding different user accounts on Windows 10, as well as how to set parental controls and more. There are a few different ways to do this, but you'll always start by clicking the Start button, selecting Settings, then opening the Accounts option. From there, select Family and Other Users from the left side of the screen. Then scroll down to Other Users and select Add someone else to this PC. Now, if the person you want to add already has their own Microsoft account, you can simply add their email address here, then click Next. Now, if you want to add someone without a Microsoft account, you'll start the same way. Under the Other Users section, select Add someone else to this PC. A dialog box will appear, and at the bottom, choose The person I want to add doesn't have an email address. An account creation page will appear. From here, you can either create a new Microsoft account or select Add a user without a Microsoft account to create a local user. A local user is one that won't need to connect to the internet to sign into the computer and doesn't need a Microsoft account or an email address. From there, you'll just need to enter a few details, like the new user's name and password, as well as the password hint. When you're done, click Next. Now, if you're using your computer at home, you can use the parental control features to set up a managed account for your children. To do this, start from the Family and Other Users section, then click Add a Family Member. A dialog box will appear. Select Add a Child, and then enter that child's email address. Do note that if you want to set up parental controls for a child on Windows 10, that user will need an email address and their own Microsoft account. Unlike previous versions of Windows, you won't be able to set parental controls for a local user account. The newly added family member will then need to confirm their invitation to your family. Once they've accepted the invitation, come back to the account settings and choose Manage Family Settings Online. A new page will appear, and from here you can choose which users you want to manage. For example, you can set restrictions on web browsing by blocking inappropriate websites, apps and games downloaded from the Windows Store. The screen time settings even allow you to control how much time a user can spend on the computer on any given day, as well as when they can use it. There's one other important setting that you should know about here. By default, your computer has one administrator account. It's the one that you first created when you set up Windows 10, and it's probably your account by default. But if you want other people to have administrator-level control over the computer, which allows them to install new programs or make changes to the overall system settings, you can make them an administrator as well. To do this, simply select the user, click Change Account Type, then choose Administrator from the drop-down menu that appears in the dialog box. Okay, there's one other thing we'd like to show you about user accounts. If you're currently signed in, it's easy to sign out of your account so that someone else can sign in, or switch between accounts. To do this, click the Start menu, then select the current user from the top left of the Start menu. From there, you can sign out of the current account, or click a different account name to quickly switch between them. And that's it. Those are the basics of user accounts on Windows 10.